Hunting. It's a sport loved by many and hated by many. Also, misunderstood by many. Thought to be a sport of just killing. Shooting an animal, getting it on the ground. And that's about it. That's what many would lead you to understand. The truth behind hunting is, there are things involved that some would never even think about. There is a lot more work involved than just getting the animal on the ground. And when you take into equation an animal that weighs plus minus 1.5 metric tons, it takes it to another level. The logistics behind recovering one of the biggest animals on the African continent makes things a lot more difficult. You need to be prepared. You need to be organized. And you need to have a team that can make this possible. Otherwise, it would be a physical impossibility.
Yeah. No, I won't shoot until you guys say that.
When you bring into the equation a disability, not being able to walk, well, that just makes things 10 times more difficult. Some would even say even more impossible. This is why we use reputable and organized outfitters to make the impossible possible. Well, what you're about to see is in Nkwazi Safaris making the impossible possible for one of their clients.
Put your hand up.
Film that, bro.
On foot, on crutches, bro.
Leads with an arrow, eh?
think that's him, mate.
I think that's him. I don't see his chest, guys.
One shot, took on one. Take it for me. Thanks, John. No, this side.
Yeah, I hit him a little bit low, bro. But I suppose you could traverse up.
Yeah, you're shooting up there.
Perfect in line with the front leg. Right there. Thank you, Dobby.
Well done.
Thanks a lot for organizing this. Got it done. It's it doesn't feel real, but against all odds and 12 days out of major surgery, I think if my surgeon and my physio found out about this, they'd kill me. We booked a giraffe hunt probably about, when was it, about 6 months ago, Darby? 6 months?
Correct.
And they really needed to take this bull off. He was getting really old. You'll see probably from his teeth and his condition of his skin, he's getting really old. He's really dark. So we couldn't cancel the hunt, so it was against all odds, so we decided to do it on crutches, and it was really cool that we got to do it on foot. It was an awesome stalk. You know, I got a 35 meter shot on the giraffe. I think I hit him about an inch or two too far forward, so he went probably about 150 to 200 meters versus the usual center hard shot where you usually see them run about 40, 50 meters. But you know, after a shot like that, we followed up for about 100 meters. We saw blood. There was so much blood for the blood trail. It made it so easy. And before we knew it, we looked up and we saw the giraffe literally on his last legs, and we saw him go down. And I think it was 5 minutes later, he was stoned. And it's difficult, but it shows you that you can do anything. Don't let a mishap or an accident get the better of you. Always get it done. You've got a passion for the sport. You know, we make sure, against all odds, we make sure that it happens. And Pops, thanks a lot. Really appreciate it. Thanks for everyone's effort with this. I haven't been able to do anything. Like, if it wasn't for everyone, this hunt wouldn't have been a possibility. So, everyone, thanks. Appreciate it. And it's been an insane hunt. Did it off crutches.
Okay.
Sweet.
Getting an animal this size on the ground is just the beginning. What happens after the animal hits the ground? One doesn't just load a giraffe onto the back of a Land Cruiser. There's a lot that's involved. You need a recovery team that knows what they're doing and that has experience. Loading is part one. Getting the animal back to his slaughtering facility is part two.
Drive slowly back.
Part three is slaughtering the animal, quartering the animal, and getting the meat into a cool room or somewhere to keep the meat cool, as so that the meat doesn't rot. Cooler boxes don't work. The only thing that would work is a cool room. Part four is processing the meat so that the meat can be used or consumption.
The amount of involvement that goes into a hunt, I think you can see it now. It's not just putting it on the ground and loading it on the back of the bucky and
You know, that's the work starts when the animal hits the ground, you know. I mean, the guys that help us, Happy, works for Nkwazi Safaris, very good at his job. They do an outstanding job, you know. They come back here, we offload the animal, they slaughter the animal, always hunt with an organized outfitter. Got a mobile cool room, there's no cool room here. We couldn't even hoist it onto the block and tackle because it can't handle the weight. Hang the meat here for a couple of minutes until there's enough to go to the cool room. We take it to the mobile cool room. I'll take you guys there now. You'll see the meat in the cool room and all the effort that goes in. I mean, a hunt like this isn't like a normal kudu or wildebeest or something like that. I mean, the work that goes into a hunt like this is crazy. And I mean, I usually get so involved with it, but like right now being in crutches, there's nothing I can do, and it's actually frustrating, but you know, we do what we can.
I personally think the key fundamental behind a hunt like this is solely the outfitter. Hunting with an organized outfitter makes the impossible possible. And in Nkwazi Safaris, I would like to thank you for making a dream come true and making the impossible possible.